Yesterday I talked about anxiety and the difference between anxiety and fear. Today I'm going to talk about fear. While unlike anxiety, which can be kind of a hazy feeling, fear is very specific. If you do not have a healthy fear of this pandemic, then we need to talk. Fear is a God-given emotion to make us careful, that is, full of care. But when it takes over your every thought, then there needs to be some kind of mental adjustment. Paul said over there in Philippians, there in the second chapter, in the fifth verse, "Have this same mind in you that you have in Christ Jesus." Jesus was hard pressed, but he did not give in to the pressure. Now we know these are difficult times. Max Licato of the Oak Hills Church here in San Antonio told the Christian Post that we've never lived in a time like this. Now we know in biblical times and church history for some 2,000 years records other catastrophic events before our time. But here we are now, we've survived. Paul over there in 1 Corinthians, there in the 10th chapter, the 5th verse said, "Take captive every thought to make it obedient to Christ." In other words, when we think negative thoughts, give them to Christ in prayer. We know he's in control, and when we say, "I'm giving my fear to you," he takes over and our fear is replaced with faith. Notice how Jesus himself recorded the most horrible time in his life. He was not fearful, that is full of fear, but faithful to his Father and your Father. As Christians, let us take our cue from him. When we are tempted to be overcome with fear, realize this is not the way your loving Heavenly Father wants you to live. I like the way Max put it. The reason God became flesh was to reveal to us the heart of God. When we see Jesus, we see God's heart. I like the way we end our Sunday morning Facebook message simply with the words, "Remember, Jesus loves you." The Oak Hills Church also has Facebook, and they say they're going to continue it for as long as it's needed. We too will continue to limit in-person services until this virus dies down. Until then, realize that this challenge is great, but our God is greater. Keep your Bibles and your hearts open more than ever before. And when this is all over, we'll look back and say, "While I was tempted to be overcome by fear, I had the God-given faith to be careful, but not fearful." Let us pray. Lord, you know what's going on in our private and public lives. We might confess that this virus can be scary, and perhaps we should. Please help us to stay safe, but not to be overly fearful, but put our faith in you. This we pray as your Son, Jesus Christ, taught us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Well, if you don't remember anything else, please remember this. God's grace is greater than our fear. And may God bless you. Amen.